But we've already mentioned that today is Money Monday, and as you know, that means we'd like to answer some of your email questions regarding finances. Pat, this first one is from Dan, who says, "Dear Pat, my wife and I have an adjustable rate mortgage that's getting ready to reset. I'm worried that my payments will spike when this happens. Should I keep the ARM and lock into a new rate or refinance into a new loan?"
Tom, I don't know exactly your situation, so I'm giving you some general information. If you are going to stay in your house at least 5 years, you ought to go for a permanent mortgage. If you're going to think of selling the house with a couple of years, you want to get out of it, you know, you could stay with an ARM. The rates on ARMs are still fairly low, and it's doubtful if they're going to spike in the next year or two. So, but my feeling is beyond that, you'd be well to lock in a low rate for a 15 or 30 year mortgage.
All right. Okay. This is Frank, who says, "Dear Pat, I'm 67 years old and need to withdraw a significant amount of money from my IRA to cover nursing home expenses for my mother. Will the money I take out be taxable?"
Yes, it will be taxable. Whatever you take out of an IRA is taxable at ordinary income rates, so you'll pay. And I think you're old enough now, so you're not going to pay a penalty on it, but you will certainly pay taxes. So you say, "Well, I pay taxes." Yes, you'll pay taxes.
Okay, Leslie says, "Our daughter just graduated from college and is now moving back in with us. How should we adjust our budget now that there's an extra mouth to feed again?"
Well, I think you ought to get that extra mouth out working. And I mean, she can do something.
Yes. Well, I'm sure that she probably will and contribute probably to the people I know.
You can't be sure unless they do it. And you need to sit down and say, "Now, dear, you've come back from college and we've put you through college, and now it's time for you to stand on your own two feet. And I want you to get a job, and room and board is going to cost so much. Maybe it's a couple hundred dollars a month. We want your share."
Yes.
"Because we're tight." And you explain to the child, she's not a child anymore, explain to your daughter what the situation is. She just thinks of you as a fountain of abundance, and you just say, "Look, we're pinched. We're having a hard time meeting and making ends meet, and we need you to pitch in." And most people want to do that. You just make it a cooperative venture. We're all pitching in together. And
it's still a lot less expensive than living on your own.
Oh, is it ever? Sure.
Yes. Okay, this is Jan, who says, "Each year my family takes time off for a nice vacation, but with the economy getting worse and worse, I'm worried that this might not be a wise idea at this time. What do you think?"
I tell you what, vacations are good, and they've got a lot of discounts now that in vacation spots, hotels. I tell you, you look at some of the places. Take West Virginia; they have some marvelous state parks. They've got cabins that rent, you know, practically for free, and you can have a terrific vacation. There's canoeing, and there's hiking, and there's fishing, and all these other things, plus some pretty good eating in some of their restaurants. Why don't you pick out some place that's not so expensive? But if you fly to some place, I think the time's come to cut back, and you can whack a big chunk off your vacation budget if you don't fly there, if you don't stay in top flight hotels. You can go down the list of how you can save.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is Sherry, who says, "Pat, what are some good ways to teach my kids about money and savings?"
Start them early, and make sure they have an allowance, and teach them tithing, for example. You know, if you give them a dollar a month or $5 a month or $10 a month or whatever the allowance is, make sure that from the beginning you say, "Now, you want to give to the Lord." And then start having them save and let them watch how money can accumulate in an account. Get them some kind of an account where they can begin to invest their own money, and it'll get to be exciting for them. But that's how you teach them. You start them one at a time. They just don't get their dollar in their little fist, and they run down to the candy store and blow it on bubble gum or whatever, or else right now they blow it on computer games.
Yeah. This is Glenn, and he says, Pat, I want to know if I should keep my current life insurance. I have a whole-term policy and only pay $18 a month. To date, I've invested $1,350 in it. I'm a 27-year-old single male with no dependents, and I'm currently debt-free. What should I do?
That term, whole-term, I wonder if our guys misread that. There's no such thing as a whole-term policy. It's a contradiction.
Maybe he means whole life, do you think?
Well, if it's whole life or a term policy, I don't know why a single person, 27, needs life insurance. Who's going to be your beneficiary? You're going to give it to your aging mother? I mean, who gets mm-hmm. the money? And I don't think you need to have insurance. Now, there's sometimes, all right, you start at a lower rate, and then as you have mm-hmm. need for term, you can add to it without a penalty. You need to research all of that and figure your own situation. Are you planning to get married anytime soon? Term life is not going to help you if you get sick. That's not for sickness. You might want to consider some kind of a health insurance. They have health savings accounts, so they're just absolutely marvelous. So you might consider one of them, but I just think a term life policy of a single male, 27, to me doesn't make a lot of sense. Mm-hmm. I may be missing something. Somebody call in and say, oh, but you don't understand, blah, blah, blah.
Well, that's part of the problem with brief questions like this is yeah. you don't have all of the details on
Well, exactly. Well, I mean, the other thing, the only thing you can think of is that you become insurable at an early age and you stay insurable mm-hmm. as you pay
Well, at $18 down. A month, I mean, that's not terrible.
Not terrible, but it's not enough to do anything for anybody. I mean, right. the payoff is minimal, so, you know, who needs it? But at the same time, if you want to begin to build it up, there's some of these policies you can get $500,000 or $1 million for very cheap. And it may be that you think, okay, well, I'm investing now while I'm healthy and insurable, and then later on I'll have something to take care of my family.
Right.